The North River, formed by the junction of Indian Head River and Barker River, flows northeasterly through the towns of Marshfield, Scituate, Norwell, Pembroke, and Hanover. The present outlet to Massachusetts Bay was formed during the gale of 1898, 3 miles to the north of the old opening. It is here that the adult alewife begins its journey towards its spawning grounds in Furness and Oldham Ponds. Indian Head River receives its water from a series of ponds, Macklin, Indian Head, and Wampatuck in Hanson, and Mill Pond bordering Hanover and Rockland. Fish passage to these ponds is blocked by a series of dams built between 1694 and 1920. Sometime after 1920, exact date unknown, a fish ladder was built at the old Clap Rubber Factory Dam located on the Pembroke-Hanover line on Elm Street. Another herring type, called the shad, tend to favor the still waters upstream of the dam, and a small annual shad run continues to this day. Alewives turn south along Barker River through one of the most pristine valleys in New England. The major part of the valley is bordered by West Elm Street to the west, Washington Street to the east, and Barker Street to the south, and contains a wide variety of plants and animals. Joining Barker River in the middle of the valley are Swamp Brook to the west and Pudding Brook to the east. Most of the valley is impenetrable by foot because of the dense growth in water-laden marshes. However, there are several high ground, dry land entry points that allow access into the valley. The Wildlands Trusts of Southeastern Massachusetts plan to build public access trails in 1999 through Willowbrook Farm and Fleetwood Farm that will include an observation platform, a canoe landing, and a boardwalk connecting Willowbrook Farm to the Misty Meadows Conservation Area. Presently, a dry trail in Misty Meadows leads directly to Barker River. In 1976, the local Boy Scouts cut a trail along a hill off of Littles Avenue. It ends where the dense marsh begins. There is a canoe landing at Curtis Crossing off of Elm Street on the Hanover side of the Indian Head River. Barker River is accessible by canoe or small boat year-round up to the intersection of Swamp and Pudding Brooks. However, any further penetration south is tight and almost impossible because of overgrowth. It may be possible someday to reach all the way to Herring Park by canoe, except in summer, when the volume of water flow is too low. South of Herring Run Park, Barker River's name changes to Herring Brook after it crosses under Barker Street. Some of the brook along this stretch opens into marshy areas, but most of it is narrow and bordered on both sides by dense trees and brush. The valley is still noticeable, but less defined in this area. Mountain Avenue provides a good sense of the topography of this valley with a low point at the center of Mountain Avenue. Between Mountain Avenue and Habermark Street lie two small ponds named Upper and Lower Mill Ponds, both of which have a small fish ladder at the pond's downstream exits. In 1958, just north of Lower Mill Pond, engineers diverted the brook 90 degrees around old mill sites and abandoned cranberry bogs that were obstructing the brook. We call this turn Corner Brook. After passing under Mill Street and Center Street, the alewives have to climb one more fish ladder at the Furness Pond Dam before reaching their spawning grounds. There is also a fishway connecting Furness to Oldham Pond, allowing spawning to take place in Oldham Pond as well. Records refer to the alewife as providing food for the first inhabitants of New England. The Indians' name for this region was Nemassikeesit, or place of much fish. At that time, the supply of fish was greatly in excess of the needs of the population. In 1698, there existed an ancient Indian weir in Pembroke that was used throughout the first third of the 18th century, until the town assumed the monopoly of the herring industry. Historically, alewives have been harvested for food, bait, and fertilizer. Alewives are caught commercially in weirs, traps, gill nets, and depth nets set in harbors, river mouths, or lakes upriver. Alewives have been marketed fresh, frozen smoked, salted, and pickled. Currently, alewives have little commercial value except as bait for cod, haddock, striped bass, and lobster fisheries. In some regions, alewives are used in the production of oil and fish meal for pet food. Trends show the overall population of herring continues to decrease. In 1920, David Belding determined that the four causes for the herring decline are destruction of spawning grounds, pollution of streams, overfishing, and the result of unwise regulation. The combined effects of these causes have had drastic long-term effects upon this species. Despite concerns about this downward trend, disruption of spawning habitats and increasing pollution levels associated with human activities has continued to the present day. Reflecting these trends, coastwide commercial harvests have steadily declined during the 20th century. The first fishery law on record, known as the Plymouth Colony Fish Law, was enacted in 1623 for the protection of the alewife. Further legislation was enacted between 1682 and 1741. Attention to the alewife was evident at one of the earliest Pembroke town meetings, and in 1717, Isaac Barker and Ephraim Nichols were empowered to hire men to go with our neighboring Indians and clear the herring brook and to prosecute the author of any obstruction. Laws continue to be written, in part, because of the prolonged depletion of river herring. Since the early 1900s, Pembroke employed a superintendent and assistant to oversee the herring run. In 1998, based on citizens concerned and the fact that the alewife has all but disappeared from Pembroke, the Board of Selectmen appointed 7 volunteer members to the newly formed Pembroke Herring Fisheries Commission, whose purpose is to study, repair, and maintain the waterways in Pembroke so as to restore the river herring population to self-sustaining levels. Present agendas include the physical maintenance of waterways, the update and repair of fish ladders, reviewing of procedures for water flow from Pembroke waterways by the Brockton Water Commission and the cranberry growers in the area, and work on getting listed on the Massachusetts State Stocking Program. In addition, reviewing water quality for fish habitation and the establishment of educational programs on our resource. The Pembroke Historical Society hosts an annual fish fry at Herring Run Park in late April, where up until recently, the fish for the fry were caught right in Barker's River. With the resource at an all-time low, the Historical Society has had to obtain the fish elsewhere. Presently, it is unlawful to take herring from the Pembroke waterways. 20th century efforts at restoring depleted stocks by constructing fishways and transplanting spawning adults has led to a significant recovery in Massachusetts waters. More than 100 rivers and streams of coastal Massachusetts are now the sites of river herring runs. Some streams are doing well, while others are showing marked declines in spawning fish. Pembroke is presently on a waiting list in the Division of Marine Fisheries restocking program, where it is expected thousands of spawning fish will be stocked into Furnace Pond. But this will not have long-term benefits unless we have the cooperation of each and every Pembroke citizen to keep our valley and herring run clean of pollution and clear of obstruction, and only then might we expect to bring back the herring in plenty so that one day each Pembroke resident may reap as many fish as he wants as our colonial brethren did 300 years ago.